And so I joke. I want to prepare his language so that you understand it. No. This is one of our scientists in our company. And this is his field of expertise. This is where he dedicates his life. Dr. Fausto. Dr. Gander. That's right. Every time I call him doctor, he calls me doctor. And another inside joke. You know, with your friends in the company, you've got a lot of inside jokes. This, go ahead, tell us.
So, sure. So what you're seeing here is a beating human heart, and this is an echocardiogram. Actually, you're seeing the left ventricle of the heart, which is pumping blood. And basically, this is the type of image that a doctor would look at when they diagnoses your heart functionality. Yeah, so this is 2D, but our body, of course, is 3D, so there is more information from this scan that we can acquire. So when we switch to 3D, we see a more complete picture, like this.
And so this basically is a scan. It's an traditional ultrasound scan coming off of a 15-year-old instrument that we then take into this computational medical imaging supercomputer, this MIS, and this is what comes out of it. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay, you take this ultrasound machine that's sitting in a hospital, it's already on the network anyways, you stream the ultrasound information into your data center, and your data center, running this stack on top of a GPU server, creates this miracle on the right, and now it's volumetric. Keep on. That's nothing. Wait.
Okay, so, at this point, we barely see basically the chambers here, and we can analyze more of the motion of the left ventricle by using deep learning. And we resort to use a state-of-the-art deep learning method. It's a fully convolutional neural network in 3D called VNet. We revisited it. We used an unprecedented resolution of 256 qubit voxel, which is 16 million dailies per scan, per frame. And we have asked deep learning to interpret it for us. And now we can see the chambers moving across the cardiac cycle, the left ventricle moving across the cardiac cycle, and segmented very well.
Now just think, you gotta realize what's happening. There's an artificial intelligence network here that is running on the original black and white gray scan that you saw. And from that scan, from that ultrasound scan, it inferred what this left ventricle, where the left ventricle is. It segmented it out. It segmented it out in motion and segmented it out in 3D. Guys, that's not amazing.
At values, we can get very precise explanation of what we are seeing and, you know, markers that tell us how well the heart is functioning. We can get the ejection fraction, the volume of the chamber and systolic and diastolic moments, and the amount of blood that is ejected with each heartbeat. We can just augment the view of the doctor in this way, in an almost transparent way. The 2D view is augmented with the 3D information.